Welcome back to Wasteland 2. Let's continue to explore Hollywood. And what the hell are you babbling about again, MP Boz? Can I talk to you? I can't. Weirdo. Officer Lamb, you do not look like an officer. Howdy, folks. How can the HSP help you today? Anything we can help you with? Thanks, but we got it covered. Alrighty then, goodbye. I feel like this is trapped. Okay. Yep. I was right. Oh yeah, I guess I might as well grab the stuff. Took the damn explosion to the face, might as well get some loot for it. Ooh! I'm not sure if I have a med pack that advanced. That might be a new tier, let me see. Max 160. Yeah, that's the next tier up, actually. Field Medic 8. Oh, it actually requires you to have Field Medic 8 to use it, doesn't it? Oh. Gotcha. So increasing your Field Medic skill doesn't only increase the amount of health that you actually heal with the med packs, but it actually allows you to use med packs. What is in here? I think the sign said it was some sort of a diner, yeah. Hello, Flo. Okay, Rangers, what'll it be? And sorry, I ain't on the menu. Well, that's good, because I'm not into cannibalism. What do you think of us? Rangers in Hollywood. Well, how about that? Y'all come here to make a cowboy picture? You sure came to the right place to be discovered. What do you mean by discovered? It's true. Lots of boys and girls get discovered at Schwag's. Plenty of kids who had their first Hollywood meal in Schwag's have ended up headlining at the Chinese. Or Heidi's Hideaway after someone like Swifty picks him up. But there's just as many who... Well, Mr. Schwag doesn't like me to talk about that. Oh, this is the place I heard in one of those, broadcasts, isn't it? Yeah, must be. Why doesn't Mr. Schwag want you to talk about that? I have a feeling this is gonna have a skill check here. Oh, it actually doesn't. Let's just say that there's... Where there's sheep, there's wolves, and leave it at that, shall we? Now, you need anything else? Wolves? I'm not saying any more about it. Tell me about this Duke Schwag. He's the boss man. Goes by Duke. Because he thinks he's John Wayne. But he ain't no cowboy, Pilgrim. Ah, I see what you did there. What do you know about Swifty? You know, it's pronounced Swifty, but it's spelled W-O-L-F. Watch out for that guy. Why? Is he dangerous? I can't say more here. Meet me in the cemetery. That's a creepy place to meet somebody, but okay. You want to meet the cemetery? Just back down the street? Mm-hmm. Some of the girls from Heidi's are having a funeral today. Oh, yes. So they are. I met them. What do you know about Heidi's Hideaway? We got a little joke about the gals at Heidi's. Want to hear it? Okay, here goes. They dance a little on their left legs. They dance a little on their right legs. and between the two of them, they make a decent living. Get it? No? She got no sense of humor. I get it. What do you know about Manny's Chinese Casino? That's the big time in this town. You make it to Manny's, you're a star. You want a good time? Get yourself a ticket. It's worth it. Just watch out for Manny's second-in-command, Grauman. All hands, that guy. Well, surely he's got some other appendages, right? Tell me about Grauman. He's Manny's pit boss. Guess he does his job okay, but he sure is a creep. Don't know why Manny keeps him around. What do you know about Manny? The gentle giant of Hollywood. A great guy. But don't try any funny business at his place. He'll break you in half. Wait, why is this option who was Flo again? Flo's her name. That's me, your hash house hostess with the mostess. Oh god, please no. Okay, I'm just going to assume everything is on a timer, so let's just go meet her right now, before something horrible happens. Anyway, the cemetery is just right here. No biggie. Oh, it's you. Thanks for coming. Sorry I couldn't talk at Schwag's, but Duke only likes us to talk about happy stuff when we're on duty. So what do you know about Schwag's drugstore? I hate that it's become such a pit of wolves, but a girl needs a job, doesn't she? At least I can try to tell the new kids who to watch out for, right? Even if sometimes they don't listen. See, look at what you did. I'm crying now. I take it something happened. A little advice for you. Don't go into Schwag's office. He gets mighty mad when people do. Don't go peeking in his lockbox either. I saw him cut a man's hand clean off for that. Wolves? They're all over this town, feeding on the poor lost sheep who come here dreaming that Hollywood dream. Slavers, pimps, psychos. I don't know why the HCC doesn't do anything about him. Old Heidi's hot pants always says she wants Hollywood to be a clean shop, but the scum are still here, year after year. Her name is Heidi Hotpants. Or Heidi Hollander, I guess? At least that's what this says. I don't like Heidi much, but she runs a clean place and keeps her boys and girls happy. A kid could do a lot worse than working at Heidi's. What do you know about Heidi's Hideaway? Not as big as a Chinese casino, but they offer more services, if you know what I mean. Dancing and cabaret up front, and then in the back you can have your pick of any boy or girl you saw in the show. The best brothel in the world, I bet. If that's what floats your boat. And what about the HCC? The Hollywood Chamber of Commerce. Most businesses in town are members. They chip in to pay for the street cops and the costs of fighting the pistol-packing priests. They're pretty good at keeping the tourists safe, but they don't seem to care so much about the street kids. And what do you know about the God's Militia? God's Militia, they call themselves. I call them the nutjobs on the hill. They think every sinner in the world should be chopped up into little pieces. Well, if killing's a sin, they're the biggest sinners ever. Come down out of Griffith Park about once a month, killing everybody they see and taking their stuff. A crusade, they call it. And taking tithes. It's straight up robbery and murder. They're the ones who should be chopped into little pieces. Alright, thank you very much. Why did that man just scream, "Those men wanted to have sex with me"? Who is those men? They're not talking about me, are they? Okay. You sell anything? What do you know about Swifty? I already asked about that, but let's see. Keep your eyes open for anything I might be able to bring to the HSP on him. I'd love to get him gone. Oh. Drugs. Don't care about them, but let's see. Do I have any junk? I do have junk. Although quite a bit of it is not actually junk. Pet rock, my lipstick, my merkins, my condoms. Hey, it's Hollywood. I gotta hold on to my merkins and condoms. Oh yeah, I guess I might as well. Yeah, let's sell this. 17 freaking pounds. Anything else big to sell? Nope. Looks like that's it. Oh, you don't have enough money. There we go. That'll do. And that is Swifty. And that's Soda Jerk. He said he doesn't like it when people go into his office. But, I mean, surely he expects people to come into his office, right? You know, to talk with him? I don't know why he'd be bothered, but at the moment I don't have any reason to actually go in there, so I guess I won't. Hey, Swifty! Butt out, jerks! I'm in the middle of a very important meeting here. You're... Say, that's quite a face you got there, kid. Anyone ever tell you you got star power? I mean it. You really got something. Listen, I'm in the middle of something right now, but here's my card. Come by the office. We'll talk. Maybe do a little screen test. See what happens. Okay? Great. Ciao. Okay. Where's your office? What's your job? Wait. He said he's busy, but I can talk to him? I don't understand. Is he busy or is he not? I'm a star maker. I make stars. You ever been to the Chinese casino? Half the girls and boys in that floor show. In that floor show? What's a floor show? I don't know. Half the girls and boys in that floor show came out of my Rolodex. And half the kids at Heidi's, too. I'm the guy with the talent for spotting talent. Now, do you mind? Thanks. I think he actually does want me to leave, so... Okay, I'll leave. Goodbye. His spirit animal is the rat. Hey, Soda Jerk. That ain't no damn soda. It's freaking pain relievers. Alright, well, why don't you take my ion beamer? Thank you. Giant food. Given how mutated everything is, it actually might literally just be giant food. Could use some healing, actually. I think that was free. Thank you. Hey, man. Welcome to the high ground. I'm George, and this is my old lady, Martha. Afraid we're not open for business right now. But if you come back later, we'd be happy to trade. Got some primo stuff. What do you know about high ground? Well, he's the owner. That's us, man. Purveyors of the finest weed in Hollywood. Clean, strong, and full of all the natural goodness of THC. Martha's also handy with needles and pills if you need to get yourself patched up or cured of what ails you. Can't help you right now, though. Maybe I can help you. Why aren't you open? Total bummer, man. A bunch of creepy crawlies are infesting our shop. Roaches as big as your leg. I haven't seen anything like them since the time I ate that bad batch of window pane. I haven't dared to go in there for days. Just been waiting on the HSP. A bad batch of window pane? What the hell is window pane? Heidi promised us they'd help us get rid of those crawlies, but we ain't seen a hide nor hair of them. Meanwhile, we're just standing here on the sidewalk, getting a suntan and losing money every day we're not open. Well, I think I can help with that. I'm familiar with roaches. Alright, I already know the answer to most of these things, but just in case there's anything new, let me just skim this. So it looks like he likes Heidi as well. Really worked hard to keep Hollywood safe, at least on the outside. But it looks like she's not doing much to fix what's going on in the streets. What's happening on the streets? A lot of nasty stuff happening in the shadows here. Assault turning a lot of kids into zombies. A lot of other kids getting stolen away in the night. Heidi don't care so much as long as it doesn't happen to tourists. Don't seem right to me. But I ain't running things. Kids getting stolen away in the night. Kidnappings or like monsters or something? What the hell? What would cause that? Can we help you? Yep. I can help you clear out the cockroaches. No problem. What do you know about the HSP? Alright, so it looks like the HSP is Heidi's private security. Okay. And what do you think of Hollywood? I love this town, man. Always something groovy going on. Always cool people to see. Me and Martha just sit and watch it all go by like it was a movie. Of course it'd be cooler if the HCC did something about the drug problem. Hollywood has a drug problem? Surprise! Salt, man. That evil shit they sell up at Hotel California. It's giving honest drug dealers like me and Martha a bad name. And Heidi ain't doing a thing about it. What is salt? Pure evil, man. I'm not just saying that because it's my competition. Pot never hurt anybody, bro. But that salt will rot your brain. And Hotel California? Zombie Central. That's where they deal salt. I don't know why the HSP can't make that place go away. Raided all the time, but it's always back again the next week. And the HCC? Oh, yeah, the Hollywood Chamber of Commerce. Yep. Who's Martha? I already know. Do you want to trade? Nope, they're closed. Okay. Alright, let's help them out. Problem solved! Cockroaches are wait, did that little dog kill the cockroaches? What in the hell? Puppy! Oh, so cute! Actually, I mean, the image looks cute, but the actual model is literally just a full-size dog that's just been scaled down. But, oh my god. Aww. Rough. Hard-ass level 8 required. I don't want to call it bad dog. No, it didn't do a bad thing. It killed the freaking roaches. Hey there, boy. How about we find you a home? Let me see if I can tame you. Wait, I can't click on it? I can't. Huh. Alright, well, they have some cleaning up to get, cleaning up to do. Jesus Christ. Easy money. Quest complete. Take this for your troubles. No problem, it took about 30 seconds. Alright, what do you got? Can't talk right now. Oh, fine. Wait, what? They just disappeared. Okay, let's go back inside. Oh my god, they still haven't cleaned it up. Nobody is gonna buy anything from you in its current state, with your shopping in its current state. Just nasty. Alright. I thought you sold marijuana. I don't see no marijuana.
Copy, Ranger Team Echo. Congratulations.
8 points, nice. Okay, even split on everything, what do I want to go with? Let's go with perception. Because I've missed a couple traps, and I'm pretty sure that's because of my low perception. Well, it's not really low, but I think it's because my perception just wasn't good enough. And Lexcanium, 3 points, not enough, okay. That is such a cute little puppy. I know, isn't it? You too look like you could use a new friend! Well, that was easy. I have a feeling that little puppy's gonna murder its owners. Alright, you're welcome. What is going on over here? There's Grommen. So apparently he's the creep. Can't even talk to him. You I can talk to for some reason. Game's blackjack, do you want to play? Sure. Place your bets. We take all bullet types. A win pays 2-1. Okay. Yeah, unfortunately, there's no visual representation of this. So I just gotta do it in text. You were dealt king and three. Your total is 13. Would you like to hit or stay? Definitely hit. You busted. My total was 19. Would you like to play again? Actually, what's the kind of ammo that I actually need? It's this, right? Yeah, it's this. Alright, go big or go home. 20. Yeah. You were dealt 6 and Jack. Your total is 16. Would you like to hit or stay? That really sucks. If I hit, there's a really good chance that I'm gonna go over. But if I stay, I'm probably not gonna win. Let's hit. Damn it! Bet it all, man. More. All of it. I'm gonna go broke. Your total is 14. Definitely hit. You were dealt 4. Your total is 18. Would you like to hit or stay? It's not very good, but hitting is too risky. Stay. My total is 20. Would you like to... Oh, fuck you. Cheater. Cheater. I'm gonna pop you one right in the head. Actually, can you imagine what would happen if I actually started shooting into this crowd? There's so many people here. Oh my god, that'd be a terrible idea. I'm assuming these are all blackjack? They are. Can I bet a dildo? I wanna bet a dildo. I can't. Can I bet a grenade? Damn. Manny Wong. You know, this is significantly less epic than I thought it would be. So this is the casino. This is the Chinese casino. It's outdoors. I was expecting like a huge casino building that you go inside of. You know, I was thinking like the original Fallouts and stuff. But this is just a couple of tables outside. Looks like you come a long way, friends. Well, you found the right place for rest and relaxation. Come on in and sit a spell. Or play a game of chance. The Chinese casino has the finest entertainment in the West. Just a moment. Those badges. Are you by any chance officers of the law? Why, yes we are. Glad to hear it. It just so happens I'm in need of officers of the law. I don't suppose you could help me with a matter of some urgency. I'd pay you for your assistance. Sure. Excellent. We, recently had a little security problem. Not that we don't have excellent security. Grauman's boys are the best in the business, but... Well, one night, some guys started a fight at the poker table. But that was only a diversion. While security were busy stopping the fight, a thief walked off with an entire table's worth of chips and managed to slip out of Hollywood before we noticed. Now, normally Grauman's boys would go after the con man and all would be well. But he's apparently holed up in an inn in Los Feliz, and that's God Militia territory. Anyone from Hollywood would be shot on sight. You, however, are lawmen, and the priests respect the law. As long as it isn't Hollywood law. What do you say? Can you get our chips back? As I said, we would pay you well. The priests respect the law. Given that I murdered some of them, I don't think they're gonna respect me. What do you know about the con man? Calls himself the King of Gamblers, which is a joke. He's never gambled in his life. He's a card cheat and a con man, who tricks other people into fighting so he can steal what he wants while they cause a distraction. We've had him on our watch list for years, but he's a master of disguise. Sometimes we miss him. These priests. I already know about them, yep. And what about the chips? Outside of this casino, they're completely worthless. Inside, they're worth a fortune. We fear this villain means to have accomplices sneak back in and cash them out. Hmm. And tell me about Los Feliz. It's a tiny place south of Griffith Park. Not much more than a couple of shops, but it's completely controlled by the God's Militia. Lunatics who want to join the cult go there to try their hand at some barbaric initiation rite. I hear 4 out of every 5 who enter die in the testing. What's this rite? Don't know very much about it. Apparently it involves fighting all the way up the hill to an old observatory, which the priests call the Bastion of Faith. The Bastion? The priests have turned it into some kind of fortress monastery. Impregnable, they say. Don't know why anyone would want it, or would want to. And what about Griffith Park? It's a park, enough said. Okay, it's a park, enough said. What do you do here? Kind of already know. Humble host, yep. Can we play a game of chance? Of course we can. Oh, there's actually more than just blackjack. There's poker, roulette, craps, Wheel of Fortune. See the cashier on the left to convert your trade goods to chips. And what can you pay for the job? Okay, cool. Tell me about Grauman. Alright, can we see a show? I'm afraid our cabaret is closed for renovations at the moment, so all we can offer you are table games. Okay. What's with these really weird questions? Like, what do you know about Manny's Chinese casino? He's the freaking owner. Heidi's Hideaway, already know about that. Schwag's drugstore. This I don't know about, though. Rambo's... Rambo's gun shop. A harmless old fellow. Likes to boast of his past glories, which I'm inclined to find dubious. A quality collection of guns, though. Nothing dubious there. He's made a fine addition to the HCC. Alright, I want to play some other games. Where's the cashier? I don't know, they're all just called man and woman. It's really hard to tell. No, I don't want to play blackjack. No, I don't want to play blackjack. No, I still don't want to play blackjack. Where in the hell's the cashier? I don't know, whatever. Sister Creep? Hold on a second. Hello? Wait. She's not here. Oh, for the love of God! Dingus. Manny Wong photos? Whoa! That's a quest item for something. Interesting. Why would his photos of him be in a safe outdoors right next to him? Illicit photos of Manny Wong. Okay. Interesting. Beware the man with the scarlet eye! Alrighty then. Goodbye. Wait a minute. There's nothing to indicate that this is trapped until I go to use demolition. That means I'm not passing the perception check, but Helen's perception is 9. You're telling me it needs to be 10? Well, I guess I'll just do that since I know it's trapped. Then again, I'm not really supposed to do that, am I? You're only supposed to know if it's trapped if you used your perception skill, right? Ah, guess we gotta blow ourselves up. It's okay, don't worry about it. Where does that go? Let's find out. Oh, Rambo! Oh, wait a minute. Hold on, am I not supposed to go in this entrance? Yeah, this is like the back door. No. I don't know if we're supposed to be there. He might start, well, going Rambo, if he sees me. Let's not risk it. What is going on with that TV? The rocky debris along this barricade looks freshly turned, as if it had been swept away recently. Looking closer, you can see a metal panel through the cracks between the boulders. Perhaps if you can move the stones aside, you can get a better look. Well, just so happens, I don't have any appropriate skill.
Ranger, over here.
What the fuck? That's Matthias? Okay, that should be interesting. First, though, I want to try a grenade. Don't think it's going to do anything, but let's try it anyway. Oh shit, it worked! Nice.
Ranger, over here.
A hatch leading underground. Yes, I heard you.
Don't worry. This isn't a trap. I just want to talk to you. I want to see if we can come to some kind of understanding.
I don't think we'll ever come to an understanding, Matthias. There can be no understanding between us, murderer.
But you see, we're both murderers, aren't we? And we both believe our murders are justified. Just as we both feel the other's murders are heinous crimes. But what if I was to tell you that it's all been a misunderstanding? That all along, we've wanted the same thing.
You want the destruction of humanity. We want to save it. How can that be the same?
Who said I want the destruction of humanity? I want the transcendence of humanity. Look, we both want a better life for people. All we are arguing about is who has the best method. So let's compare. You want to give people a better life by catching criminals and imposing order. So let me ask you, is it working?
Yeah, of course it's going great. I've left behind a massive trail of dead bodies. If that's not progress, I don't know what is.
Really? Is there still crime? Yes. Has any police force ever stopped all crime? No. Will any amount of enforcement ever stop all crime? No. And why? Because enforcement doesn't fight the root problem, which is human need. Transcendence will.
Okay. I'll bite. How will transcendence solve need?
Simple. When our minds and souls are contained in synthetic bodies, we will not need food. We will not need water. We will not need shelter. All the things that we humans rob and steal and kill each other for will be made completely obsolete. We will need the sun to power our batteries, and that's all. There will be nothing left to fight for. Everyone will have enough. Isn't that a beautiful dream? Isn't that worth fighting for?
Well, yeah. It is beautiful, I suppose. I mean, it's true if you removed most of the things that people fight over. Give everybody essentially eternal life, kind of. Remove the need for food, water, and all those things, then yeah, the amount of fighting and disorder and whatnot would vastly go down. But you've got a damn ugly way of attaining it.
No dream is ever won without struggle. But at least my way ends with the end of violence. With your way, the violence will never end. So will you join me? Will you fight for the transcendence future?
Wait, can I actually join him? Is that a thing I can actually do? Because that's gotta majorly affect the story. Well, I'm sure as hell not joining him. I am curious what would happen if I did do that, though. This just sounds so cheesy that I don't really want to say it, though. The we'll fight for the right future? The Ranger future! And then I just imagine everybody in my group just, like, standing in a circle and doing the, you know, touching the hands in a circle kind of thing and just going like, Rangers! Yeah! Awesome! And stuff. Go, go Rangers! Power Rangers. I guess I'll say it.
I know you were too thick-headed to convince. It's really too bad. Had you said yes, I might have spared your friends at Ranger Citadel. Now I'm afraid there's nothing you can do to save them. We fly to Arizona in a matter of days. How will you ever live with the guilt?
No need to. I'll just solve all of the problems in the entire world and get a train back to Arizona within 2 days and stop you. See? Easy. Vertical Advisors LLP. We're on the up and up. I bet you are. Okay, where does this go? Whoa. That goes to Griffith Park? Interesting. Alright, I'm just gonna file that away. Now I know that's there. Don't actually want to go there yet. Okay, it looks like... I think Hollywood actually might be very small. I think I've almost explored all of it. Goes to Los Feliz. Which is probably where I'm going to be going next. To go do the quest. Which is what? What is the quest again? I don't remember. Wait, we should confront Schwag and see what's going on. Should we? Okay. Ah, right, the stolen chips.
Manorites, beware. You think the Desert Rangers are your allies. You think that just because they have helped you end the Robinson Uprising, that they are your friends. They are not. They sided with you because they believe you to be the weaker and easier to manipulate. Los Angeles, can you believe the flagrant lawlessness of those so-called law bringers, the Desert Rangers? Freeing a condemned
criminal
further their ruthless ambition. The Manorites have come
from
to
the children of the new citadel.
Them into their homes.
A personality test.
Will your town be next? Do not let the Rangers too close.
Oh my God! You're never going
to
stop talking, are you?
Soon you will find yourselves under their thumb. Remember, the children of the Citadel are your only true friends in Los Angeles.
All right. Thank you very much. Are you interested in finding out if you got the personality to attain a brighter future? Do you want to know if you're compatible with Matthias' vision of a new world? Then take our simple test. It only takes a minute and costs absolutely nothing. What do you say? I think your image here in your profile is kind of terrifying, but sure, I'll take it. Excellent. We can do it right here. Are you ready? There are 5 questions. Question 1. Do failures in your past continue to haunt you? Nope. Do you get occasional muscle twitches with no outward cause? Nope. Have you ever had a strong emotional connection to an inanimate object? I feel pretty connected to my merkins and dildos, yeah. You're walking in the desert and you see a tortoise on its back, baking in the sun. Do you turn it over, or leave it as it is? Well, apparently I bury it to death, but I turn it over. Do you think one life matters? Yes. Got it. Now let me look over your answers. Very promising. Very promising indeed, friend. I think you have what it takes to be part of Matthias's golden future. Of course, before we can be certain, we need to do further tests, but I don't have the facilities to do those here. You'll have to go to the new citadel itself, which is far to the south. Just present yourself at the Pilgrim Welcome Center and our indoctrination specialist will take care of the rest. Why would we want indoctrination? Did I say indoctrination? I meant education. Uh-huh. Tell me about the children. We are the children of the new citadel, devotees of Matthias and the future that he is building there. Tell me about this future. Out of the citadel shall rise the sun that will illuminate a new age of prosperity and hope. All that join Matthias in the synthesis will share that future, and we will live in peace and harmony for all eternity. Synthesis? It's the holy wedding of the immortal human mind and spirit to the immortal body of the machine. Only when all of humanity achieves synthesis will we transcend the horrors of this world. Who's Matthias? I already know. Yep. What is the new citadel? Headquarters of our church? Yep. Okay. Ma Brown. And Rat Boy. What's going on, Rat Boy? You wouldn't think a beard and a tutu would go together, but somehow Rat Boy makes it work. No? Not condoms? Pet rock then? Dolls? Directions? Snow globes? How about this one? It's got Manny's Chinese Casino being showered in tiny golden coins. What about a souvenir condom from Heidi's Hollywood Hideaway? Wait, what do you mean not condoms? I totally want condoms. I'll even take pet rocks. Give me everything. Let me see what you've got. What do you have? Okay, that might be too many condoms. Lickin' Stick Quarterly. He's got 20 merkins. I can buy 1,340 scrap worth of merkins. Those are some expensive condoms. God damn, where's Planned Parenthood when you need them? Riding spurs? What kind of riding? Alright, well, I'm gonna buy all the porno mags, which coincidentally cost 69 scrap. Vibrator? Yes. I'll take 4, thank you. Thank you. Let's see the condoms. Are these the special ones, or... Oh no, just takes you the trade. Tell me about Heidi's. Yep, already know all that stuff. Directions, don't really need it. Okay. So I know I can come back to him if I need directions. And who did I buy these with? Alright, let's distribute vibrators to everybody. Unfortunately, I don't have enough. Some porno mags, here you go. Luxcanium, Pazepi. Bound to please. For not enthusiasts? Lickin' Stick Quarterly. Magazine about popsicles? Mistress Knows Best? Sounds Victorian. Ma Brown. Unfair. Sorry, folks. The Brown Crown is closed. The goddamn HCC shut me down. Changed the locks and everything. Do you need help? Help? What is there to do? I'm supposed to get a sworn statement from Ossifer Lamb. Ossifer Lamb. I'm just gonna call him Ossifer. I needed to get a sworn statement from Ossifer Lamb over at the HSP. That I've cleaned up the place. But it's already clean and Lamb knows it. He's just not going to say so until I cough up the dough. Well, I got my pride. I'll die before I pay those snooty bastards. What if we talk to Lamb? You mean, lean on him? Well, don't be too hard on him. It's not his fault. He used to be one of my best customers. He's just doing what his boss tells him to. But if you could get him to sign the statement, well, you'd have free chili for life at the Brown Crown, friends. I swear it. Okay, so what is the Brown Crown? I take it it's a restaurant? Yep, restaurant. Best chili joint in Hollywood. Okay. Health coach, already talked about that. Nothing wrong with it. Okay. Okay. Alright, well, I think I'm going to end this episode here. So, I guess I've explored pretty much all of the main Hollywood area. I've gotten all the quests here that I can find. Just need to, start going inside, I guess. Start completing some quests. I know I need to go back to the, Rambo's gun shop, and of course go to Las Feliz and do that quest, and yeah, a bunch of stuff to check out, but looks like I've mostly covered the street area of Hollywood. So, we'll do some further exploring of Hollywood in the next episode.